To remove the power supply, first remove the side cover, the top fan, or CPU water cooler, depending on whether the system is air or water cooled. And any graphics cards installed in the unit. Remove the motherboard bracket assembly. The cable holder. And the power supply cover. If you bundled cables together when removing the cable holder, remove the cable tie that secures the power supply connectors with any other connectors. Detach the power supply connector from the front I/O board. Remove the front I/O power connector from the cable clips at the top of the unit. As well as the cable clip under the middle bracket of the PC. Detach the hex screw that secures the AC inlet to the bottom of the PC. A hex wrench is provided in the toolbox at the front of the unit if a tool is needed. To access the tool, partially or fully remove the voodoo cover and pull out the wrench from its slot on the toolbox. Detach the Phillips No. 2 grounding screw for the cable. Pull the cable off of the power supply and remove the cable from the unit. Remove the three remaining Phillips No. 2 screws that secure the power supply to the chassis. Each screw is indicated by a stencil of an arrow. Do not remove screws that are unmarked. If the unit has a 1300-watt power supply, slide the power supply partially out of the unit for better access to the SATA power cable junctions. Detach the five power supply cables from the SATA power cables, four for the hard drives, and one for the optical drive. You may now fully slide the power supply out the rear of the unit. If replacing the power supply, detach the four Phillips No. 2 screws for the power supply bracket on the power supply and remove the bracket. Install the bracket on the new power supply with the four screws. The handle on the bracket should be on the top of the power supply. To replace the power supply, feed the power supply connectors back into the power supply cage. And slide the power supply partially back into the unit. Attach the five SATA power cables to the power supply. Each power supply cable is labeled Device 1 through 5 and should be connected to the matching labeled connector for the hard drives, 1 through 4, and optical drive, 5. And secure them in the cable guide under the middle bracket of the PC. Fully slide the power supply back into its bay on the PC. Secure the power supply to the PC with the three Phillips number 2 screws in the three screw holes marked with an arrow. Leave one unscrewed, as this is for the AC inlet grounding cable. The AC inlet end of the AC adapter cable for the power supply has a rail on one side that fits into a slot on the power supply cage. To replace the AC adapter cable, first press the AC inlet into place. Replace the power supply end of the cable to the power supply. Replace the Phillips number 2 screw for the grounding tail of the cable in the fourth stenciled location on the rear of the power supply. Replace the hex screw to secure the AC inlet to the bottom of the PC. Replace the front I/O power connector into the cable guide under the middle bracket of the PC. Secure the front I/O board power connector into the large cable clips at the top of the PC. Reconnect the front I/O power cable to the front I/O board. Replace the cable tie to secure the motherboard and CPU power connectors to the USB 3.0 connector if you are bundling cables for ease of replacement of the cable holder.